The dreaded Delta variant has now spread to around 100 countries, including the Philippines. This highly infectious variant has become the dominant variant in parts of the world, and it's also being blamed for a surge in cases in some countries. So far, the Philippines has dodged the Delta threat as strict border and quarantine measures prevent the variant from reaching communities.
It's now the more dominant variant, especially nga po sa India, UK at kasama po ang United States. More than 58% yun sa mga bagong nahahanap na kaso ay positibo po para po dito sa Delta variant.
In Southeast Asia, Malaysia and Indonesia are reeling from the Delta variant.
Ito pong Delta variant ay nakita na po sa bawat estado sa Malaysia, no? Kaya nakikita nila baka pwede pa pong lalong dumami ang mga kaso nila sa mga susunod na linggo. Sa Indonesia, umabot po to as high as 54,000 cases per day noong last July 14, no? Yung mga new reported cases nila. And this is 10 times higher than what they saw at the start of June.
Infectious disease specialist Dr. Ronjin Solante says it's critical for government to strictly enforce travel restrictions amid reports the Delta variant was able to gain a foothold in some countries because of loose travel protocols.
When we see cases like this in neighboring countries, especially in those countries na mas malapit sa atin, then we really have to have that border control. A border control should also include yung sa dagat at saka yung sa ibang pamaraan na makapasok dito sa Pilipinas.
Solante warns the Delta variant is a constant threat and the public plays a critical role in keeping it out. He maintains the country's health system will not be able to bear a Delta-fueled surge similar to Indonesia.
Kailangan ang sambayanan ay alam ang posibilidad na maaari at dadating tayo dun sa punto na papasok at papasok itong Delta variant dito sa atin. Pero ang importante, kailangan handa na tayo.
For many experts, it's no longer a question of if, but when the variant will be able to enter communities. This comes as some local government units face rising coronavirus cases. According to the latest report of the Okta Research Group, Cebu City and Lapu-Lapu City have seen an increase in COVID-19 infections after reproduction numbers reached 1.37 and 1.80 respectively. Mariveles in Bataan has an even higher reproduction number of 2.23. The National Capital Region is a bright spot with a reproduction number lower than 1. The group asserts it's better for a government to maintain all measures that prove effective in reducing the number of infections, including quarantine restrictions. Malacañang is keeping NCR under general community quarantine until the end of the month. Other areas under GCQ include Baguio City, Cavite, Rizal, Quezon, Cotabato, and Surigao del Sur. Other areas under GCQ but with heightened restrictions are Cagayan, Laguna, Antique, and Davao City. In the meantime, Bataan, Iloilo Province, Davao de Oro, Davao del Norte, and a few others will be under the stricter modified enhanced community quarantine. The rest of the Philippines will be under modified general community quarantine.